morning, Mavericks, and welcome to MBC News. I'm Jessica Ramirez.
And I'm Matthew Benheim. Thanks for tuning in. Well, today is the last week of February, which means AMHS students are scrambling around to get those last-minute courses selected for next year. Now through next Friday, freshmen, sophomores, and juniors must meet with the guidance department during English class. Here are a few tips to ensure your visit with your counselor is a smooth one. Bring a copy of your re-registration fee and tuition agreement and receipt along with your colored form given to you in English class. If you applied for three or more honors or AP courses for next year, fill out and bring a class waiver form. And if you're unable to meet a counselor during English class, feel free to email your guidance counselor with any questions or concerns. It is very important to bring these forms to pick your classes to be sure to stop by guidance throughout the week to submit your course selections.
Please come see me after school if you're still not sure, or before school, and I'll try to help you in any way that I can.
We are well underway with our season of Lent, and Griefold has celebrated with Archbishop Wenske on Ash Wednesday. All four classes, in addition to community members, joined in Mass. But just what does it take to pull all of this together in just a few hours of time? NBC News reporter Kayla Sipex shares how preparing for school Mass all together comes together.
It takes a lot to put up a school-wide Mass, from the physical setup of the chairs to the electrical technicalities with the sound check. Everyone has to make an effort each month in order to make the Mass a success, beginning with Liturgy Club to make space for the fellow worshipers.
Of course, Mass wouldn't be Mass without the Holy Helpers, the Eucharistic ministers and altar servers who volunteer with utmost reverence.
Representing the school and giving back and being able to be a part of the liturgy, and it helps us be able to express our love for God.
After the rushed preparations and hectic setups have ceased, however, it truly is an amazing experience.
Thanks, Kayla. And AMHS juniors got a feel for the college life last week as about 50 students bust their way through the state of Florida to visit various universities. Some of the stops included UF, FSU, USF, and UCF.
So the college route was really rewarding actually going on it, because, you know, you picture the colleges in your head and how you want to go, like your whole life and your whole high school experience anyway. And going, like, seeing the campuses, like the full college tour, like the full college campus and life, very active, was great. My favorite was UF. I loved it. I loved how happy the people were. I loved everything about it, and yeah.
Be sure to sign up next year to tap into all these colleges have to offer.
Well, Mavs, it's quite the week in the world of entertainment. So here's what's happening on the teal carpet. Have Mercy! This Friday is the premiere for the most anticipated show of the year since its ending in 1995. Full House makes a series spin-off tonight as a new show, Fuller House. Want the old jokes, Miss Mr. Woodchuck? Well, you got it, dude. Full House will be available on Netflix tonight and many Mavs can't wait. So grab your favorite 90s scrunchie, a box of popcorn, and get ready to binge-watch the series tonight. I know I will. So grab your favorite 90s scrunchie, a box of popcorn, and get ready to binge watch the series tonight. I know I will. And grab your popcorn again, because this Sunday marks the 88th Academy Awards, better known as the Oscars, hosted by comedian Chris Rock. A few of this year's nominations include The Revenant, The Martian, Spotlight, and Creed. Will this be Leonardo DiCaprio's year, which he finally wins an Oscar? Make sure to tune in to ABC at 8:30 p.m. this Sunday to be in on all the action. And don't forget to check out the pre-show at 7 p.m. to watch your favorite celebs walk the red carpet in this year's latest fashion trends. I know that's my favorite part of the show, so y'all better tune in. Well, here at Archbishop McCarthy, fashion is a big influence for our student body. The Lokai bracelets have taken Mavericks by storm. Each Lokai is infused with elements from the highest and lowest points of the earth. The bracelet's white bead carries water from Mount Everest, and its black bead contains mud from the Dead Sea. These extreme elements are a reminder to the wearer to live a balanced life, staying humble during life's peaks and hopeful during its lows. Through this season of Lent, I'd say that's a pretty meaningful reminder. These bracelets are extremely popular, so we went out and asked some of you why you wear it and what it means to you.
Well, I actually really, like, really like Lokais.
I guess they're a cool thing, but then at the same time, I don't really agree with them. Like, sure, like, they promote a message, but I feel like besides bracelets, there should be, like, another way to promote the message that you're trying to get across. Like, I don't know, like, going out and doing something instead of wearing a bracelet.
So I just figured out what these bracelets were just recently, and I like them. I think they're a good way of bringing awareness to causes. They seem very similar to the old flat bracelets that people used to use for cancer awareness and things like that. So I think anything that brings awareness to causes like that and pulls people together, it's a way of showing solidarity and pulling people together. I think it's great. Anything we can do to come together as a people for a cause is great.
So if I could hang out with one person, it'd be definitely Jennifer Lawrence, because she's just hot.
Sean Connery, I like his accent. I would love to hang out with Naruto.
Definitely Ethan and Hila Klein, because they're just so incredibly sexy.
It gotta be Adrian Peterson. One of the best running backs of all time. And yeah, that's my role model.
Bob Ross, because he's a great painter.
Hey, maybe we'll wash this brush. What the heck? I just really like to wash brushes. Keeps my crew here on their toes.
Kodak Black, because he's such an influence to the kids in Pembroke Pines. Because he's the hottest rapper out right now in Pembroke Pines, and he's going to make it far.
Taylor Swift, because she's everything.
For the state of Florida, and he's gonna put Pembroke Pines on the map, and once that happens, that's gonna be so important for all the kids.
Sylvester Stallone, because he's a stud.
Not just Broward County and Dade County and Palm Beach, and it's gonna be amazing for us. It's like Drake, how Drake has done so much for Toronto, Kodak Black can do a lot for Pembroke Pines.
If I could choose only one, it would have to be my boy Fetty Wap, because we look alike and people all the time are telling me that I look like him when I'm walking down the street. I mean, the eye's a little different, but other than that, you can see that this is, identical.
Literature fans all around the globe are mourning the loss of the passing well-renowned author Harper Lee last Friday. Many of you have read her most popular novel, To Kill a Mockingbird, back in freshman year. At the age of 89, Lee received the Pulitzer Prize along with many other awards and recognized for the book To Kill a Mockingbird. It will forever be a classic, and Lee's legacy will live on forever.
Well, it was an exciting week for the Maverick baseball team as they got to play in Marlins Park. Zachary Oliveri has more in the Mav Sports Zone. Zach?
That's right, guys. The Mavericks baseball team had a memorable 6-5 win against Matter Lakes on Monday at Marlins Park. Junior Alex Trout showed his best Giancarlo Stanton impression by blasting 2 home runs and totaling 3 RBIs on the afternoon. Senior Kobe Lopez drove in the game-winning run in the 6th inning. This wasn't the first time the Mavericks baseball team graced the same field as players like Marlins' Jose Fernandez, D. Gordon, and Giancarlo Stanton, but this experience was just like playing on a field of dreams.
Great, playing in the same park that Major League Baseball players get to play in. Just a blessed experience.
Well, playing in Marlins Park is a special experience, both for, our team, our players, and our coaches. We get to be big leaguers for a day. So it sure is nice, running around on that field. And even though the stadium's not full, it's a wonderful experience.
The Mavericks baseball team returns to their own home diamond tonight as they take on Blend Jesuit with first pitch at 7 o'clock sharp.
Just try to play the best baseball we can. They're a good team. We're a good team. It's going to be a great game. Hopefully we come out winning.
Well, tonight's game against Blend is going to be a good one. They always have a very good team, very well coached, and they challenge us every year. So we're going to really have to play our best. We're hoping all the Mavericks come out to support us. We're looking forward to a great game.
And now staying on the diamond as the Lady Mavericks softball team have stormed out of the gates to start the 2016 season.
I think that we have a lot of good, solid talent, especially some of our freshmen that have stepped up. They've contributed greatly. And I think one of the things is that we also have some senior staff that on our roster that have helped mold that youth, and they're gelling right now, and it feels good. I think the girls are excited and enthusiastic, and I think they play better when there's a little bit of, shall we say, that camaraderie that comes with being on a team.
They'll also return to action tonight as they host Calvary Christian Academy Lady Eagles at 6:30 sharp.
Calvary Christian, it was added to our schedule later, and by all accounts, they're supposed to be a real solid team, both fundamentally, and they have a decent pitching group. So we're looking forward to play them. It'll probably be the best test that our ladies have already played this year. And then, of course, on Tuesday, we play American Heritage here at McCarthy at 6:30. And we're hoping that everybody comes out. This will be a big test. You know, the softball program, our theme this year is the Year of the Phoenix. And the purpose of this whole thing is about rebirth. And with the group that we have right now, we're off to a good flying start with everything. And we're hoping to continue and start building a real good tradition here at McCarthy with softball.
That's all this week, Mavericks. I'm Zach Oliveri. Back to you.
Thanks, Zach. Well, that does it for this week's show. I'm Matthew Benheim.
And I'm Jessica Ramirez. Thanks for tuning in, and be sure to tune in next on NBC News.